Welcome back to Let's Play Baldur's Gate Siege of Dragonspear. Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Move aside, people, move aside, Corwin says. Refugees say the Fist needs to march on the crusade. Stop hiding inside your fancy palace. It's a little chaotic out here. Guess you couldn't tell. Most of these people are refugees. Or not people, like horses and dogs. There's a couple named people here. There's a Perrin and Garrison over here. We have a few quests. We need to go to the three old kegs to pick up Dinah here in Minsk. And find some people who took our gold. Long story. See the end of last episode. And if we go to the Thieves Guild, we can pick up Safana or Karan. Karan may be a good chance will be less annoying than Safana. And TX, I believe, is a gnome cleric at the Flaming Fist headquarters. And this is someone else at the Elf Song Tavern, a few other people there. Garrick. And, not sure who else. People we're not familiar with. I want, Kagan and Branwyn, but apparently they're not about. And Imowyn is injured and inside the, Ducal Palace there, healing up. So let's talk to... We can go off the map. Let's talk to Perrin.
Fine.
I thought life couldn't get any worse when I lost my home. Let me tell you, that's the sort of thought you should never think. The gods take thoughts like that as a challenge.
Garrison says, need a place to sleep? Step right up. Plenty of room inside. My doors are open to all. I think he means to rent a room. I think the answer to this is no, but I'll ask it anyway. You've opened your home to the refugees? An admirable act. Apparently it's true. We have a moral obligation to be generous and open-handed with these poor folk who have lost everything to the Shining Lady's rampage.
Generous? Open-handed? Ha! If we didn't lose everything before, we surely did after we enjoyed your hospitality.
What's going on here? Silence, you ungrateful... I mean, not all the refugees are as grateful as they should be. No matter. I continue on my mission of mercy. Yeah, I don't understand him. Am I to understand that you profit from the refugees who stay with you? Perrin says, profit? Nothing. He takes every scrap we have left. Clothes, jewelry, trinkets we carried hundreds of miles. Doesn't matter. He takes it all. And those who have nothing get no shelter from him. Well, how am I to offer lodging without some sort of income, hmm? Feeding you lot isn't cheap, and the laundry bills, outrageous. I've nothing to be ashamed of here. You're wrong. These people are desperate. You're taking advantage of them. When you put it that way, bah, perhaps I could charge less, a little less. I still have to feed this lot.
You call that slop food? Three people up and left last night, figuring they'd have better luck getting a meal at the Iron Throne. And that was after they'd paid you your blood gold.
If you really want this lot fed, go to the Elf Song Tavern and get me some provisions from Lady Elith. But don't expect me to pay for it. Not one copper. Oomph. Move along, then. Refuge for the refugees. I could go to the Flaming Fist headquarters and ask about Garrison, or I could go to the Elf Song Tavern to secure more provisions for him. Garrison, a homeowner with a large house near the Ducal Palace, has been taking everything refugees have in exchange for lodging. He claims he will open his house if I secure provisions from the Elf Song Tavern. A refugee named Perrin mentioned several lodgers had left for the Iron Throne. I wonder if this is worth mentioning to the Flaming Fist. Okay, so this is the guy's house. I was under the impression that it was an inn. These refugees and their ceaseless whining. They're getting on my nerves. And you are getting on mine. I'll be going. Goodbye, ma'am.
I need to find a way to start life over again. Somewhere far away from this tick-infested flophouse.
Alright. We have a few things to do. Let's talk to this dog. Dog has nothing to say to you. The nerve of it, of that thing. Alright, so we can't go in there. Exit. Alright, let's see if there's anything else to see, anyone else to talk to before we head for the exit. Can I go world map? Okay, 3 old kegs. Okay, the entire place isn't opened up. We have a choice of 3 old kegs, Iron Throne, Flaming Fist, or Elsong Tavern, and that's Sorceress Sundries, which for some reason is not listed on the map, but I remember it well. Right, anyone else to talk to here? Doesn't appear so. I serve the Flaming Fist. Clear the way. Hello, horsey. They should have horse noises for that. And the dog. Alright, let's go to the 3 old kegs. And we do have a quest here to deliver the money, but we can buy provisions there as well. And that would be better if we buy provisions when there are people to carry them. Gold says, let's roll that lout with the glowing staff? As Sari says, yeah, I like the look of him. What are they talking about?
The 3 old kegs isn't far from here. There's a pair of Rishemi travelers staying there. Duke Eltan thought you might speak with them.
Yeah, I definitely want to pick them up. It's Minsk and Diner here. These refugees. Yeah, talking to refugees. We got, chickens as well, and a cow.
Please, help us.
Even if the crusade ends, life will never be the same.
I'm so tired.
I just want to go back home. The first time he actually says something that's in the dialogue. There's some commoners here, actually. People that actually normally live here. If I can get to them. I've heard what they say about you. How are we to trust someone with Baal's blood in their veins? I don't care if you do or not, to tell you the truth. Alright, so where are these people who were talking? Asari? Louise? Oh, there's a box here. How about the fancy lady with the orbs around her head? Durla says. Louise says, nah, she's got a knife in her boot. Roll a wizard? You want to get fried? Pass. Are they playing D&D? Seems like they are. Talking to horses and cows. Alright, let's talk to Asari, I suppose.
There are many ways of dealing with such as you.
Robel says, welcome to 3 old kegs. Asari says, looking to lighten your purse, chum? Louis says, well, what do we got here? Just a concerned citizen. Is that right? Maybe you should just shove off before you get hurt. Okay, they weren't rolling a character, they were checking out characters. And leave you to your larceny? I overheard you. I know you're searching for a target to rob. And? You're offering yourself as a pick? Now that I think of it, you got the look of someone with a bit of coin in your pocket. Colt says, hey, that's right. You tell him, Luis. Luis says, how about you hand over every copper you have, and maybe we'll let you go. How about you give me all your gold, and maybe I'll let you go. Derla says, I don't think you quite understand the way this works, friend. Get her! Okay. So we get Sari, Luis, Derla, and Golt.
What?
I haven't been able to sleep, so I don't really have any spells. I have this. I'm not getting involved. There's blood getting shed, but it won't be mine. Commoners are panicking. As are refugees.
A simple matter.
Whoops. Where's, what's her name? Corwin. Corwin is not helping. Oh, she's, using a bow.
Yes. I am wounded.
Yeah, no kidding. Take your
What is fine?
Okay, good. There's blood getting shed, but it won't be mine.
Menial tasks.
Looks like a good time to run like hell's away from here.
What is a simple matter?
I'm kiting.
What a simple matter?
The problem is these people are in the way.
Yes, a simple matter.
Good. What do we got here? Oh, it's Golt. Okay. I don't need any of this stuff. Okay. Portion of healing. Gold necklace. Full of stuff, though. Treasury note. Okay, I can put that there and then pick this up. Darts. They're just regular darts. That container's full too. Damn. I have a feeling I'll be dropping the gold necklace soon. Yeah.
What is it? A simple matter?
Did I open this? I think I did. It's Get out of my way, people. Oh, it's locked. Before we got stuck. There's Robel. And this is the... three old kegs. Voted best in Baldur's Gate. 3 years running. Seems like three is the number to be. Let's talk to a couple more refugees before we go talk to Robel.
I'm so tired.
I heard that Kalar's Crusade made it all the way to Bridgefort.
Please, help us.
The Crusaders must be stopped. This is a time for heroes. Hey, watch where you're going. Bloody heroes. Think we should worship the ground they walk on. My joints are acting up. Storms are coming. Mark me on that.
Please, help us.
Someone has to stop the crusade.
Please, help us.
Oh.
I'm so tired.
Yeah. Come on in, folks. Come in and slake your thirst at the three old kegs. Yeah, it's, day is approaching. Alright, let's get in. Well, let's talk to Robel first.
Hear ye, hear ye!
I'm not trying to do that voice. Welcome to the three old kegs. Step through this door and experience one of the finest inns Baldur's Gate has to offer. You must be drumming up quite a bit of business. Oh, yes. The streets are packed with refugees looking for lodging. The Iron Throne building offers temporary shelter to those who can't afford rooms for themselves. I'm here to let those that can know the Three Old Kegs offers excellent quality at a fair price. The Iron Throne building offers temporary shelter. Alright. This crusade may be bad for the Sword Coast, but it's been a blessing for us. The work does get a bit tiring, though. I wonder if I could ask you a favor. What is it? I've been shouting out here for hours. My voice is starting to go. If you're going inside, could you ask Kathira to send a drink out for me? What's in it for me? My thanks? You don't really expect payment for a few seconds' work. I make it a habit to hope for the best, but expect the worst. I'll speak to this serving wench for you. Thank you. She's inside somewhere. Usually the main floor, I think. Must return to work now. I should talk to Kathira inside the three old kegs. The Dry Creek. Or Crier, actually. The Crier outside the three old kegs is parched. I need to ask Kathira inside the inn if she'll send out a soothing drink for the Crier. Bloody hell, I'm parched. Any word on that drink? Not yet. Let me know when you've talked to Kathira. Alright. So we have a few things to do in here. Let's get inside. It'd be good to have our companions back to get some rest.
I'll await you here until you're ready to go.
Where are Dinah here in Minsk? They've got a room on the third floor, or so I've been told. When you leave, don't move too far ahead of me. If I lose you in the crowd, Duke Elton will have my head. Recruitment drive. Corwin will wait for me at the entrance to the three old kegs. Captain Corwin knows the city well. With the streets as crowded as they are, I thought it would take far longer to reach the three old kegs than it did with her guiding me. She's waiting for me at the three old kegs' front doors while I look around. When I'm ready to go, she'll follow me out the door. Sounds like a plan.
Finished? Menial tasks. I'm ready to head out when you are.
I need a drink. You? Sure. Why not? What can I get you? Wine. She says. Coming right up.
So, the hero of Baldur's Gate. Tell me about yourself.
So, Sapphire, the woman, the myth. I'd rather know about you.
What would you like to know?
How did you come to join the Flaming Fist?
Ah, well, therein lies a tale, but it's a long one. My father, Audemar, was a fist. You could say I followed in his footsteps.
Many children emulate their parents. Not me, thankfully. Say, what are your thoughts on Kalar?
A charismatic leader. An acolyte of the Order of the Aster once. She claims divine favor for herself and her forces. That's why so many flock to her banner. She'll be a formidable opponent.
That she will, but why? What is she hoping to accomplish?
We'll find out soon enough, I suspect. But what she wants is of little consequence. It's what she actually does that matters.
True.
Whether the battle's long or short, glorious or horrific, it's going to happen. Kalar's got to be stopped. She's driving people out of their homes, seizing their goods, forcing innocents into service. We can't let it go on.
We won't. I can promise you that.
Drink up. We've things to do and not much time to do them in.
I shared a drink with Captain Corwin. I didn't learn much about Corwin. She seems to keep her private life strictly private. I'm not sure if she learned any more about me. She didn't. But she seems willing to work with me to end this crusade business. I suppose she'd say anything more.
More wine? I'll not have any more myself, but you're decent enough company for the most part.
Ha! For the most part?
Take it as a compliment.
Oh, you are a woman of refinement and taste.
You noticed. Good eye.
I'm noticing a lot of things about you.
Don't look too hard. You might not like what you see.
Ooh. Dangerous, are you?
Let me know when you want to leave. Finished? I'm ready to head out when you are.
Someone tried to kill me tonight, and I'm in a bar. Hells no, I'm not finished. When you are, you know where to find me. All right. Chara.
Tis always good to give a little tip.
Good morning to you, ma'am. How can I be of assistance? Tell me about yourself. Who, me? There's not much to tell. The tavern needed someone to run the taps, and I needed some coin in my pocket. My man's a sailor, so he's gone for weeks at a time. This keeps me busy and lets me talk to people. I must get lonely from time to time. Go on, you. I'm happy with my man. Flatter me though you will. Now can I get your charming self a drink? I've already had a couple drinks, I think. I don't have much money. This actually is not my money.
I hope our establishment's to your liking.
What can you tell me about this place? The Three Old Kegs is one of the oldest taverns in Baldur's Gate. Never thought I'd be working somewhere so fancy. Nantrin Belloglim runs the place. Alright, have to be going now. Good morning to you. These commoners? You're not fooling anyone. We're watching you. I'm watching you too. Have a good day, ma'am. Someone ought to. Alright. More commoners. The apple doesn't fall far from the tree. The whispers are true. Your apple falls from a twisted tree indeed. Saravok's journal claims you're as his kin. What do you say to that, child of murder? Apparently nothing. I can't get to that guy. Who's that? The Omnian Delight is the ricketiest tub I've ever seen. You hear me over there? Was it Autin? Oh, that crew's spineless. They don't even care when I say their captain is a doddering half-wit. You don't know port from starboard.
What a simple matter.
That ship of theirs shouldn't just be hauling garbage. It should be towed away as garbage. That's it. Get him. Bar fight? Oh, I could talk to the bartender or one of the captains if I want to put a stop to this fight. Really? There's nothing why he wasn't talking to me. Seems like a bar fight is brewing in the three old kegs. I could talk to the barkeep or try to intervene between the two parties if I want. Alright, so it looks like Lucilla? Also got some sailors here. Commoners. Barkeep is Nantrin Bellogloon, as she mentioned. Here's the bartender mentioned. Here's a, another sailor. Let's talk to Lucilla. Nantrin says, stop, stop. Everyone calm down. You there. You're the hero of Baldur's Gate. That title is a bit grand. I only did what anyone would have done. I'm sure of it. It's you. Can you help settle this? I don't want to have to call Ithtil and the other enforcers. It's a hell of a name. Lucilla says, this isn't your business, stranger. Keep out of it. Why fight when you can drink? That's all I'm saying. Let's sit down and have another round. Auten says, I know you, hero. You were mixed up with Saravak. Everyone's talking about it. Why should we listen to you, hey? You might have the darkest soul in here. I ended Saravak's threat. My soul's no darker than anyone's here. Prove it. Lend us a hand against the Omni and Delight's crew. Violence rarely solves anything. Lucilla says, there's no talking to a lackwit like Auden. Violence is all he understands. And you? You seem reasonable. Reasonable, aye. But I'm also a crew member of the Omni and Delight. I'm gonna beat this codfish cuddler into the ground. How about you give me a hand? Is a fight worth it? Your captain will likely find out. And I doubt she'll be pleased. How do I know their captain's a she? The stranger's right. We don't have time to engage in petty brawls. Martin says, ah, none of you have any spirit. Come on, mates. Let's look elsewhere for fun. Yay, I managed to defuse a potential bar fight in the three old kegs. Nantrin Bellogloom, the owner of the inn, usually doesn't permit fighting, and more than one rowdy patron's been thrown out of the bar. When he saw me, though, Bellogloom asked me to intervene and said he'd trust me to handle the situation. My face is more well-known than I thought. Well. They're leaving, which is good. And Lucilla is gone as well. Let's talk to Nantrin. Greetings, hero. Greetings. I dealt with those rowdies for you. How'd you get those sailors to stand down? I couldn't tell you. Take this bit of gold as thanks. Glad I didn't have to call Ithtil down here. Much appreciated. 200 gold. Have a good morning, ma'am. Alright. I guess we...
Good day to you.
Any drink specials for heroes tonight? Fine wines by the tall glass. I'll take some of that gold and have a Berduskan dark wine. Fight broke out here last night. We were able to handle it, and a good thing too. It took hours for the Flaming Fist to arrive, and they only sent one officer. The situation on the streets is getting worse and worse. We're having a lot of fights here. Hope everything works out. Ugh, who's this? Nathbera.
Tis always good to give a little tip.
I don't levitate tankards to customers' tables anymore, and not since the... Well, just not anymore. Noted. Kathira.
Tis always good to give a little tip.
A very good morning to you. Can I get you something from the bar? Oh, yeah. I gotta make sure I have room in my inventory. Nothing to drink right now. Tell me, do you ever have trouble with the patrons here? Yeah, a fight last night and today, and I'm asking this. Not usually. Bellow Glynn runs the inn well. Our patrons know better than to drink too much or start a fight. You're a beautiful woman, though. You must get a lot of attention. Well, aren't you a charmer? The other servers here and I are all experienced hunters. We can take care of ourselves. Good to know. What do you serve here? Mostly wine, but we have a few casks of mead. Alright, let me just check, make sure I have... No, I don't have space right now. Unless... Now I do.
I hope our establishment's to your liking.
Robel, the crier working outside, is losing his voice. He could use a drink. Mercy, we barely have drink enough to satisfy paying customers. I'll send one out when I can. But it may be a while. It's basically the same thing. Robel's working so hard to bring customers in. I'm sure you and the other servers have benefited from the extra hours and the tips. The least you can do is get him a hot drink. All right. You've convinced me. I'll have the kitchen mix some hot lemon water with a bit of rum and honey. Send it out right away. Thank you. I'm sure Robel will appreciate it. Well, back to work. Enjoy your stay at the Three Old Kegs. The Dry Crier. I should talk to Robel, the crier outside the Three Old Kegs. I convinced Kathira to send a drink out right away, even though the inn is very busy. I should let Robel know. Yeah, before I go upstairs, I'll do that. Some commoners here. Look at all these refugees hanging about. Put them to work, I say. Have them clear the beasties out of the sewers. That's a level one quest there. I can't believe it. You're really the hero of Baldur's Gate.
Keep a good distance now.
Saravak never stood a chance against someone like you. Oh, thanks.
Can't hardly move in these streets.
Seen that one before. Alright. Let's go talk to Robel.
Such menial tasks.
Bloody hells, I'm parched. Any word on that drink? Kathira will send that one out right away. Thanks for the help. I appreciate it. Here, take a few coins for your troubles. 30 gold and 300 XP. I must return to work. Enjoy your morning. I relayed Kathira's message to Robel. He's looking forward to receiving his drink.
I'm actually quite shy!
The crowds keep pouring in. Thanks again for getting me that drink. No problem.
A simple matter.
Okay, believe it or not, we've yet to advance to even the second floor of the Three Old Kegs. Dinah here and Minsk await on the third floor.
Yes.
Anyway, I'll call an episode this time, for now. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time, and always seek adventure.